Charles, will you tell us about the fire department?
Yes. I think that the Historical Society has somewhere a picture of the group of men who got together to start the fire department. And Henry Reno, John Reno, Wilfred Nye, Howard Atwood, our father, Arthur Clark, they're all in that picture, and they got together and they built the fire station that everybody knows about, that Dana Dakin bought and converted down in the village, the wood frame building. It had a concrete floor. The wood from it came from our farm here. In fact, I was in there with Dana once, and I could see the writing on one of the inside of the boards left when they marked up the timber. The timber came from here, and the men built a fire station. Just opposite the Emmons house, known as Deep Well Farm, which is at the corner of Campground Road and Village Road, behind the post office. It is now a residence, having been replaced by a newer, larger station on Route 11. The first fire truck that I remember seeing was, I think, an old American LaFrance. It was used, had big cylinders on it, and it was quite a thing, but it was a used piece of equipment, and it didn't see a lot of use. We had a water tanker, and the water tankers were all old, used oil trucks that had not been used as oil trucks for a long time. They were sort of cleaned out, painted red, had a pump on them to get the water in from a river or a pond or something. And that was usually the first thing that went to a fire. And then the other truck had the ladders and the hose. The fire department met, I think, either weekly or every other week, and up in the upstairs of the fire station. They raised money by selling chances. They had a raffle every week. And Bob Stewart from North Wilmot worked for public service, and he used to sell a lot of tickets. And everybody at the meeting waited for Bob to show up with his money and decide, and then they'd pull a ticket out, and usually one of Bob's people on his electric route won, but sometimes it was someone locally. They also had a dance every Saturday night over at the town hall. It was square dances called by Wilbur Grace and his band. And they were highly attended, very popular. The town hall floor got a good workout at those square dances, and they did some round dancing also. And there was usually a fireman's picnic in the fall up at Kearsarge, Wensell State Park, where all the families got together and enjoyed that. One of the biggest fire problem we had was, frankly, was the town dump, because people would go and dump there, but maybe didn't want everybody to know what their lives consisted of, so they'd touch a match to it, and of course the fire took off, and so the big fire whistle would go off down here, or a phone would ring probably, the dump is on fire. So my father would drop everything, and I was at that point in time 8 or 9 or 10, and we'd run down the hill. We didn't have any transportation, so we'd run down or drop down and go to the fire station. And since most of the members worked out of town, we got the truck down to the dump and pour water on it. We had two dumps that I remember. One was out behind the Slider's house. And in fact, their son's house is basically where the dump was. On Campground Road, yes. And there was a windy road to get in until finally they built the road that is now the driveway to the Slider's son's house. And that was there for quite a while, and we had fires there. And then it was down at the transfer station, and there were fires there. And then the town went to a co-op and took their dump down to, I think, Andover for quite a while, and then we came back to our transfer station, and that's went from dump to transfer station for ecological reasons, obviously, environmental reasons. And then the reached the point where they the town was appropriating money to support the fire department because they couldn't raise enough money for what they needed, and their town was growing, and it was necessary to get another truck and newer trucks, more reliable equipment. And so the new station was built down here in the late 1990s, I think, 1990s, I think it was. And it's grown enormously, modern equipment and so forth. So it's come a long way. The fire department meetings, when the meeting was over, there was a card game. I mean, I think the card players couldn't wait till the meeting was over so they could play a little poker. But we didn't stick around for that. My father was not, he didn't drink, he didn't smoke, he didn't play poker, he didn't gamble, he didn't believe in any of those things. And so we would get up for the meeting and walk home.
Good afternoon. Today is April 30th, 2021. I'm Liz Kirby with the Wilmot Historical Society, and I'm visiting with Charles Thompson at his home on Crossroad Road in Wilmot. We're asking Charles to tell us some of his memories of the Wilmot Fire Department over the years that he was familiar with them. Wilmot Fire Department did not exist until, I believe, it was 1942. Is that correct?
I would have said then, or maybe a little earlier, but somewhere around 1942, yes.
Were there any forest fires during that time frame?
There were forest fires during that time frame. Some were distant that we could see from where we lived, top of Mount Sunapee, the top of Corbin Park over in Grantham and Cornish. But there was also a fire in the probably around 1952, 51, 52, somewhere there. Ernest Patton was logging the Victory land over between Cross Hill Road and Route 4A. And there was no real reason why he would have started the fire. It was in the springtime, when the ground was dry and the leaves were dry, but he was logging with horses and a wooden scoot. So there was no real instance where there'd have been a spark or something like that. Now, whether somebody threw a cigarette or dumped their pipe ashes out, who knows? But it burned about a quarter to a half of an acre right over the property boundary between the Thompson property and the Victory property. And today, this day, you could go out there to that spot and still see the scars at the butts of those beech trees that are growing where this fire burned into the roots and up into the stumps of the trees and made a big scar and a hollow in the tree. And you can tell which direction the fire was going because that's the side that has the burn hole in it. And you can stand and see one and look around and see others facing you from where it had been. At that time, Proctor Academy had a fire truck, and the Proctor students, the Proctor boys we called them because they were high school age, got probably great enjoyment out of, or excitement out of jumping on their fire truck and going to a fire. A forest fire, and they were very good. They had some training, and they had tools. They had an open fire truck that had no roof or anything. It was a vintage machine, and they'd roll up and grab their tools and go out and work on the fire. I'm sure it's been years and years since that happened, but that was part of the firefighting capability of the area at the time. There were several big fires over the years. Churches, of course, and the Methodist Church at Wilmot Center, and the hotel on Mount Kearsarge.
The medical services that they provide have really expanded over the years, from what I understand also. Is that right?
That's true. In fact, some of the firefighters have suggested that the Wilmot Fire Department is really Wilmot Fire and Rescue because they have the FAST squad, first arrival sustaining treatment or something like that, that has the capability of transport and also of immediate care to make sure a patient who is in some medical emergency in town is cared for until professional medical help can come in the form of an ambulance. Usually that's the way it works, or a doctor. But they have a very well-equipped truck, a nice piece of equipment, and people who are trained in it, formal EMT training, and it's, again, another important aspect of the department.
Thank you very much. Wilmot is a really amazing town in many, many ways. It's retained its vintage personality, but it has kept up with the times and provides the services that could not be equaled anywhere else in a town of this size.